Mr. Spade, did you bring me any news? I mean, did you manage it so that the police won't have to know about me?
Well, they won't for a while anyway.
You are wonderful. You won't get into any trouble, will you?
I don't mind a reasonable amount of trouble.
Do sit down.
You aren't exactly the sort of a person you pretend to be, are you?
I'm not sure I know exactly what you mean.
The schoolgirl manner, you know, blushing, stammering, and all that.
I haven't lived a good life. I've been bad. Worse than you could know.
Yeah, that's good, because if you actually were as innocent as you pretend to be, we'd never get anywhere.
I won't be innocent.
Good. By the way, I saw Joel Cairo tonight.
Do you know him?
Only slightly. You're good. You're very good.
What did he say?
About what?
About me.
Nothing.
What did you talk about then?
He offered me $5,000 for the Black Bird. You're not going to go around the room straightening things and poking the fire again, are you?
No, I'm not. What did you say?
I said $5,000 was a lot of money.
It is. It's more than I can ever offer you if I have to bid for your loyalty.
That's good coming from you. What have you ever given me beside money? Have you ever given me any of your confidence, any of the truth? Haven't you tried to buy my loyalty with money and nothing else?
What else is there I can buy you with?
Your secrets are. But I can't go ahead without more confidence in you than I've got now. You've got to convince me that you know what this is all about, that you aren't just fiddling around, hoping it'll all come out right in the end.
Can't you trust me a little longer?
Well, how much is a little? What are you waiting for?
I've got to talk to Joel Cairo.
You can see him tonight. He's at the theater. It'll be out soon. I'll leave a message at his hotel.
He can't come here. I can't let him know where I am. I'm afraid.
My place, then. Hello? I want to leave a message for Joel Cairo.
All right.